Job had no Jerusalem Baptist Church
All right.
Mentioned anywhere in the 40 plus chapters. Job had no priest that was mentioned anywhere in these chapters. Have we got a witness? Job didn't have what you and I have seen with the Ten Commandments.
All right.
Because the Ten Commandments did not appear until the children of Israel were being released.
All right.
From bondage and were already in the wilderness. Have we got a witness?
Man.
So if you don't know that, is that what is pastor and all those other preachers talking about is because didn't the Lord create the heavens and the earth? Didn't it say that in the first book of the Bible? Well, it does say that, but that is because Moses was recording all the things that the Lord had done even before the book was written. Have I got a witness? So now you and I have a chance to take a close look as to what happened when a man loved God and was more than just ritualistic. Didn't come to church just because he wanted his name on the roll.
All right.
Have I got a witness? We've got some people now that say, well, I don't want to go to anything that's not already looks like a church.
All right.
Man. I'm going to come and I'm going to join up as soon as y'all find y'all a place. What kind of foolishness is that?
Oh, man.
Job had none of those trappings. Job was not devoted to rituals. He was devoted to God. Have you got a witness? Do you know that somebody's not happy until the whole auditorium is full? Somebody won't say amen until you want to be seen? Is that you and I? So as my father used to say, is that you can keep your money, give me some fish. He said, well, the lady said to my father, well, I didn't charge you enough or more. He said, keep the bread and give me another couple pieces of fish.
All right, man.
us, right?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And he's showing just how much the Lord had done.
Yes, he is.
But one thing I would like you to look at, and seminary would advise you of, is look at the fourth verse. Mm-hmm. His sons used to take turns having parties.
All right.
At their home. They would send an invitation to their three sisters to eat and drink with them. Mm-hmm. And the fifth verse says, whenever a round of banquet was over, Job would send for his children and purify them, rise early in the morning to offer burnt offerings for all of them.
Yes.
Have I got a witness?
Yeah, man.
For Job thought, perhaps my children that I've given everything in the world, I just give them my heart.
Yes.
My children.
Yes.
And I want them to have something I didn't have.
All right, Lord.
Mm-hmm. Have we got a witness? I don't want them to ever struggle.
Two.
Do you see it?
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
Right here in the first five verses.
Yes.
And then you ask, what happened in the next six verses? I want you to look very, very closely at that, because we spoil our children.
Amen.
We say that they don't need what we, many of us, were compelled to do.
All right.
All right. I'm not gonna force them. Well, well, I'll just leave it at that. Job's children had everything.
Yes.
Had a billionaire for a father. Yeah. Plus. And they were not as dedicated, neither were they taught.
Amen.
To honor God.
Amen.
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 And then you ask, what is this world coming to? And every time we move into a phase of honoring our children and youth, and we start thinking about what has to be the dedication, and what can be the expenses, and how we need to show them love, and how do we need to just don't let them get away with us.
All right.
Amen.
We have pride. Oh, I just want to come to church. Well, keep your focus on what God has said. Suffer little children to come unto me, and forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of heaven. Well, Pastor, I didn't know that was going to be your subject. Well, the subject is inclusive.
Amen.
And don't sit back and say there's no collusion.
All right.
There's some sin here.
Yeah.
That needs to be corrected.
Yeah.
That there are some things in which we just take for granted.
All right. Yeah.
And when all that God gives us is that we turn our head when it comes to what have we done with what God has given us.
Yes. Yes.
But I just want to spend the last few minutes talking about just how mighty God Almighty is. Because the sixth verse gives you and me, and remember this happened all before the writings of Moses in Genesis, he gives us a phenomenal view of the stage in heaven. The first five verses are all on earth. The sixth verse is in heaven. God didn't come down and to earth to ask the question or to have the assembly in the sixth verse. This was a heavenly stage. Let's see. One day, the Son to heaven, neither did he have access to the church.
All right.
Have we heard of
it? Man.
And it turns out that Satan was as much of an angel.
All right.
Yes, he was.
As any other angel.
Amen.
A spirit.
Yes.
Have we heard of this?
Yes.
That's why don't get disappointed as if you're sitting up within church and somebody said, well, because angels are allowed access in both heaven and earth.
Yes.
And when the rapture shall come, he will then restrict all Satan's angels, the demons, to the earth.
All right.
But for now, they are walking to and fro all over the earth. And every time there's a faculty meeting, every time there's a meeting that is called by God, the sons of God, and that includes the angels that are devilish,
yes,
will show up.
Yes. Yes.
That's why it's so hard to do sometimes.
Yes.
Have we got a witness? Is that every congregation has angels in it.
Yes.
And those angels are both good. You said it.
All right.
Have I got a witness? But the sixth verse of the first chapter of Job has given me a new perspective, and so you don't come to church with your feelings on your shoulders.
All right.
Because somebody is sure to knock it off.
Yeah.
And there you say it. Have I got a witness? Oh, I thought I was in church. Let you know. That God is not only mighty, he's all mighty.
Oh, my man.
Because he handles things in which we have taken for granted.
Amen.
So, in the sixth verse, it says, without any complication, that, that is equivocation, that the Lord asks Satan. And if this had been a meeting on earth, which many of us thought before we looked at it as seriously as we're looking at it now, is that the Lord certainly knew, but he was letting him know that I know what you've been doing. You've been roaming the earth.
All right.
And I just want you to tell me where you come from.
Lord have mercy.
Have we got a witness?
Amen.
Well, give you the A point to let you know that Satan is a ferocious villain who victimizes. He wants you to sit up in church. He wants you to sit at home. He wants you to sit in the job, on the job, and in school, or wherever you're sitting. And he wants to make you and me feel like a victim.
Amen.
He had no other purpose. He's a deceiver. He's a cheater. He does everything that you and I don't want done to us.
Amen.
And he's ferocious.
Yes, he is.
If you look at the definition, the English definition of ferocious, is that you'll see that a person that won't stop. Mm-hmm. He churns and he twists things. And he makes things sound like they are not.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Have I got a witness? Oh, I've never found a better person that I must want to be with them than to be with some people in those churches.
Amen.
I would like to spend my time on Sunday morning doing something else where I can be around people that I know.
True.
Well, the Lord said is that our duty and our devotion and our commitment should be in worship. Have I got a witness? Well, look here, because you will find that there is an amazing amount of scripture that's about to come your way. Are you there?
Amen.
The seventh verse, when he answers. That is continuation of the seventh verse. I'll tell you what the devil does. He wrongs. And if you had any questions about whether this is the planet in which he wrongs, he's wrong, but understanding of the eight planets, it could be in Mars. But the Bible says that he roams through the earth.
Right. Mm-hmm.
How many of us are still living on the earth? And he said that I'm walking around it.
Mm-hmm.
Have I got a witness?
Yeah.
I used to tell you all the time is that if Satan is in here, somebody opened and kept the door open.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Yes. And Amen. Walked in with somebody else.
Amen.
Have we got a witness? And let's see here is that then the Lord said to Satan, have you considered? Now consider in this text is a military term. Strategy for capturing a person that's devoted to me.
Right.
that is, I know, Satan, the Lord was talking to, I know who you've been looking at.
Yes.
I know whose heart that you have been checking out.
Yes.
I know what strategy you've been using to get my most devoted and committed servant, Joe. And no one on earth is like him.